Okay, let's move
so.
On. Up next,
next we have a Springer Spaniel, and it's possibly the first or second we've ever had in the freestyle competition. And this is Susan with her dog Gilly, Exmoor Dark Sky. They're making their first ever appearance in a freestyle competition here. They have taken part in rally, so Gilly should be used to the atmosphere. But as I know, Gilly is a bit of a character, you know, typical English Springer Spaniel. So let's see if he can keep his brain on the job today. Well done, Susan, with Gilly there, showing a really nice advanced move there at the end. Dog standing up on its hind legs with something in its mouth. And that's quite hard to teach the dog, to hold something and do a move. And there was another lovely advanced move there where the dog hopped forwards on three legs away from the handler. So that's what I was talking about, advanced moves. Now, if you didn't already know, they were performing to the Pirates of the Caribbean, and one sort of test I was always sort of told as a handler is try to do your routine in costume and turn the music off and show it to somebody and say, can you recognise what the track is I'm using? Because you should be able to tell without the music playing, and I think there we would have easily have got the music just through the props and the staging and the movements that we were seeing from this team. We would probably have got Pirates of the Caribbean. So Gilly there doing some lovely jump moves, and you see he's such a happy dog. I'm so pleased he got through to the end and concentrated throughout. So we have Trip Hazard in first place at the moment with 24.20, and then we have Yolanda the Panda with Emma Perry. She's in second place on 23.53. So let's have a look where we are with the scores. Remember, this is out of 30 points. Now, I don't believe there'll be any deductions there. Gilly's normally a very quiet dog when he's working, concentrating on what Susan is asking. So into fourth place with 21.60. And that was a good example of a theme-based routine. And today you'll see more of those theme-based routines or story-based routines. Tomorrow is a heel work to music. And so there might be a slightly different slant on the type of music used, just due to the discipline of heel work to music. So our next dog is running order six, is Christine Hodgson. And she is her second time in this big arena, but it's actually Ziva's first time performing to Colours of the Wind.
You think I'm an ignorant savage, and you've been so many places, I guess it must be so, but still I cannot see if the savage one is me. How can there be so much that you don't know? You don't know. You think you own whatever land you land on. The earth is just a dead thing you can claim. But I know every rock and tree and creature has a life, has a spirit, has a name. You think the only people who are people are the people who look and think like you. But if you walk the footsteps of a stranger, you'll learn things you never knew, you never knew. Have you ever heard the wolf in a circle.
Well done, Ziva, completing her first ever routine in this ring here, and a sort of controlled performance with a sort of emotional feel there, but with some lovely interpretational features. When the dog was howling up to the moon, I think it was, and there was another rollover and the handler and dog was rolling over. So when you've got music like this, you can't hide. It's not fast and furious, and so the dog has to hold things sort of that little bit longer. And so that's the beauty about this sport, is you haven't got elements you have to do in freestyle. You can really make that routine the best it can be for your dog. So if your dog doesn't like doing something, it doesn't really matter, because there's so many other things you can do. And as I always say, your dog will be good at one thing that somebody else's dog isn't. So you can make that move that the dog really loves, you can make that look harder than somebody else's dog who doesn't perhaps do the move quite so well. So a nice sort of flowing routine there, and use of the music from Christine and Ziva. So our first place dog at the moment is still Trip Hazard on 24.20. The judges have done their scoring. So we've got a bit of a different scoring there, sort of some eights from one judge and then down to some 6.7, 6.5 from another judge. But you really have to look at where the judges started with their scoring, because actually the distance between their sort of first and second place scores might actually be the same. But that's into third place, or 22.90. So again, a nice happy little dog running around there with his tail up. And it's just so nice to see these dogs enjoying their time out there in the arena. Now our next dog is running order number 7, is Carol with Brooklyn, a 11-year-old border collie called Kinaway Dr. Foster. They're going to be performing to I've Got No Strings. Now Brooklyn is a bit of a free spirit, and he thinks life is one big party, but we hope he's going to keep his brain in gear today. And Carol's a very experienced handler, not only in heel action music and freestyle, but also in obedience as well. So he's had a great grounding, and obedience is a great way to start with your dog before you get into this sport. So pop along to your local dog training club and then start off doing some of the tricks, some of the moves that you're seeing here today. Well, another controlled sort of performance there from Carol and Brooklyn. And so it's not all about running around, you see. You can make it just to suit your dog. And at 11 years old, you know, Brooklyn has got a series of moves there in the toolbox. And we were talking about obedience earlier, and one of the features of obedience is the dog holding things in its mouth during a retrieve. And you saw that during that routine. Carol made use of the fact the dog could pick something up in its mouth, and so the dog shut the book and it helped her soar as well, and held a little prop at the end there. And the judges will be looking at how they used those props, because the props should always be sort of part of the routine, and you try to use those props, you know, a few times in the routine to get sort of maximum marks, because if you only used it once, it's perhaps not quite as good as if somebody uses a prop many times. So we've got a few more to go now, but it's looking quite good at the moment for Lucy Heath with Trip on 24.2. So let's see if Brooklyn with Carol can push them off of the top spot. So there's many points, there's about 4 points under each of those categories, content, accuracy, interpretation, that the judges have to take into consideration. And you know, I've judged there in those seats 3 times, and it's quite a bit of pressure there with everybody sitting around watching, but these judges are very experienced, they've done this many times, so in their heads they can make these sort of analyses of the routine quite quickly. So again, a little bit of a difference in marks there from our first and third judge, but as I say, you have to look at what they marked the other dogs, because they might have been low for those as well. So into fifth place with 21.73. So we've got 3 dogs to go. And we've got another collie next, so, but not a black and white one like Brooklyn was. This is a red Merle. She's 6 years old, Demelza, with her handler Jill. Now, Jill is a very experienced handler. She's been in this main ring with 2 other dogs, Holly and River. And I've seen her many times performing here at Crufts. So, another emotional sort of type of performance, because she's working to a song called Medal of Honor. what a lovely ending there. And as the title of the song said, Medal of Honor, with Jill giving to Melza a medal at the end. And that's an important part of this storytelling in freestyle. You've got to sort of have a start, middle, and end. And the start is going to grip the audience and grip the judges. And then the middle's got to sort of take the audience somewhere. And then you've got to build up to this ending. And you really want the crowd to go wild, don't you, at the end and clap. And you want the judges to give you a high score. So you want to come up with some ending which really epitomizes the track of music that you're using. And another sort of controlled performance from Demelza there, and some nice moves from her with the different types of weave as she went through and into the forward and reverse weave, which I often think is one of Jill's trademark moves. I've seen her do it many times with her dogs. Demelza is 6 years old. I'm sure we're going to see her back in this arena over the next few years. There's competitions up and down the country. We have qualifiers as far as sort of Scotland, right down on the south coast. And so there will be always some qualifiers or competitions if you are interested in competing in this sport. So some reasonable scores there from all the judges, and no deductions by the look of it. So into third place with 23.07. So that's a nice bit of holding the object and performing another move. Because the dog could have just held that object and just walked along with it, and that wouldn't have been as advanced as placing its feet on the drum and then pivoting around. So that obviously impressed those judges, and they gave some reasonable marks there for Demelza.